Welcome to church.
We're so glad you are joining us today. What a wonderful day to be alive and to give God all the praise. Well, my name is Serrano McKenzie, and I'm a junior here at Valor Christian College.
Yes, my name is Audrey McKenzie, and I am also a junior here at Valor Christian College. And today, we are so excited to be your campus hosts today. And listen, today is going to be a great service. It's going to be great. We got a lot of things planned. And so make sure you guys like, comment, and share.
Absolutely.
You know, sharing is the easiest way to evangelize. So make sure you share this live.
That's right.
On your Facebook, on your Instagram, anywhere you can share it, really. You know, text it to somebody. Text them the link.
Yes.
It's the easiest way to evangelize. So get it to the people you love, the people you care about, even strangers that you don't know. Get it to them so they can be touched by God's love this Sunday morning.
Yes, let everybody hear and know that God is moving here at World Harvest Church. Well, we have something coming up called Bunny Breakfast on March 23rd at 10 a.m. You do not want to miss it. Easter season is coming up. It's going to be a great time. It's a wonderful time for the kids to come and just take pictures with the Easter Bunny. It's going to be an amazing time. Free breakfast, games, and more. So be here March 23rd, 10 a.m. We want to see you, and it's something for the entire family. So be here for that.
Absolutely. And you know, Easter is coming.
Easter's coming.
Easter is coming. It's where we get to celebrate our Savior's victory over death, hell, and the grave.
Yes.
It's always, I just love Easter time.
It's
always have ever since I was a kid. And getting to be a part of Easter at the Harv, it's even better. So
even
make sure you come. We will have service on Resurrection Sunday at 10 a.m. And it is not something you want to miss.
You don't
want
to miss
it. You definitely want to be part of it.
Absolutely. Fun times around here at the Harv. Always an exciting time. We always believe God for miracles, for signs, and for wonders. God is going to move, and he's going to do great things this Easter season. Don't you miss it. Well, let's see who's watching. We
have
so many people watching. Let us know where you're watching from.
Yes, comments. Comment. Up first, we have Gail Green. Yes, she's watching with us. We have Deborah Ward watching with us from Detroit, Michigan.
Awesome.
That's where I'm from, Flint, Michigan.
She's from Flint.
Thank you for joining, fellow Michigander.
Thank you for joining us. And who else we got?
We have our Elkhart family.
We have Elkhart family joining us.
We see you, Elkhart, and we love you.
We love you. Well, service is going to be great today. Don't go anywhere. Share, because service begins in 90 seconds. Praise the Lord.
Good morning, good morning. Everybody,
good morning.
Let's stand to our feet.
Yes.
Let's gather and together to worship the Lord this morning. It's a good day to be in the house of God,
isn't it? It's a great day to be in the house of God. And we're so excited that you decided to join us today. Listen, get ready. Let's worship.
Yes.
Let's praise God. We believe it's going to be a wonderful day in the presence of the Lord. You ready to worship?
Hallelujah.
Say yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right, let's welcome Harvest Music Live. Let's worship.
Father, we bless you, and we thank you that we have assurance that we belong to you. You know right where we are. You're working all things together for our good. So grateful, Father.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. And know what a foretaste of glory divine. I'm an heir of salvation, purchased of God, born of his spirit. Oh, I'm washed in his blood.
Oh,
and we can't stop singing.
Oh,
this freedom song.
Oh,
that hit with his blessed assurance.
Blessed assurance,
Jesus is mine.
Jesus is mine.
Oh, what a foretaste.
Oh, what a foretaste.
Of glory divine.
Glory divine.
Heir of salvation.
Heir of salvation.
Purchased of God. Out of no way,
yes.
He washed you clean,
yes.
Say yeah, yeah. You'll never leave us. You'll never forsake us. So good to be on the winning side. Now somebody just shake loose a big hallelujah. Stay right there. Just shake loose a big hallelujah. Oh, I felt that shift right there. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, Elkhart. Come on, Instagram. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah to our resurrected King. Hallelujah to our kinsman redeemer. Hallelujah to the lover of our soul and the lifter of our head. Hallelujah to the only one that gives new life. Hallelujah to our King who reigns forever. Hallelujah to the healer. Lord, we thank you for your healing power that is alive and well and resident right where we are. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, church, lift up that hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, beautiful. Lift it up, lift it up. Lord, we thank you, Lord. 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 Thank you, Lord. All right, come on, hands up all across the room if you're able, everyone online. Father, we thank you for the privilege of your presence, God. Oh, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. You are welcome, you are welcome, you are welcome here, oh God. With no resistance, Father, you are welcome.
We say yes, Lord, yes. Our songs are rising in your direction. We say yes, Lord, yes. And we will wait on you. We will wait on you.
Come and move. We say yes to you.
We say yes to you.
Come on, let's tell them yes all together.
Come and move.
Uh-huh.
We say yes to you.
Father, come and move.
Come and move. We say yes to you.
To our King.
Come and move.
We say
yes to you.
All over again, Lord.
Your face, our focus.
Your face, our focus.
Your will, we are wanting.
Your will, we are wanting.
We say yes.
We say yes, Lord, yes.
Your glory invades.
Your glory invades.
And we're changed forever.
We're changed forever.
We say yes.
We say yes, Lord.
Tell them all together.
We say yes to you.
Beautiful church, lift it up.
Come and move. We say yes to you.
Come and move.
Come and move.
We say yes.
We say yes to you.
Father, come and move.
Come and move.
We say yes.
We say yes to you.
Oh. Lord, come and move.
Come and move.
We say yes.
We say yes to you.
Father, come and
move. Come and move. We say yes to you.
Father, come and move.
Come and move.
We say yes.
We say yes to you.
We say yes to you, Lord. Now, come on, somebody, place a demand on the goodness of the Lord. Yeah, God. Here's what we believe you for, Lord.
Exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we ask or think. We said exceedingly,
abundantly, above all that.
Yeah, yeah.
We ask or
say.
Exceedingly, abundantly,
above all that.
Above all that.
Come on.
We ask or think.
Ask and say.
Exceedingly, abundantly, above all that. Exceedingly,
yeah.
Abundantly,
above all that.
Above all that. We ask for it.
We know you're able. We stand on your holy word.
Above all that. We ask for it.
We say.
Exceedingly,
abundantly,
abundantly,
above all that.
Above all that.
We ask for it.
We ask for it.
Yeah.
Exceedingly, abundantly, above all that.
Come. next Sunday, right? Not one of the easiest Sundays of the year when you lose an hour of sleep. However, you know, sometimes to gain something, you have to let something go. And we could focus on the loss, or, like Scripture said, he focused on the joy that was set before him. While you're walking through what you're walking through, we could focus on the problem, we could focus on the hour of loss, or we could think about springing forward. So if I was you, I wouldn't be worried about the loss, but I would be thinking about sometimes you gotta let something go. Sometimes you may encounter a loss so you can move forward. And sometimes a loss really isn't a loss. It's just God saying, I'm getting ready to elevate you. And that was just extra baggage that you can't take into the new season of great things that I have for you. So I'm looking for somebody that will buy into that this Sunday morning and begin to take your praise up another level, because you're believing for exceedingly, you're believing for abundantly, and you're not worried about what you've lost. You're so excited about springing forward into the goodness of the Lord. Is that anybody today? We say exceeding, exceeding, abundantly, above all. Yes, God. Yes, God. Say, do it, Lord. Move it, Lord. Hey, hallelujah. Yeah. Oh. Say, he's gonna do it. He's gonna do it. He's gonna do it. He's gonna do it. Yeah. He's gonna. Yeah. He's gonna, whatever you need, stand on his word. I know my God, and I know he is. Yeah. He's gonna do it. 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 I heard him say, he's gonna fix it. He's gonna fix it. He's working right now. All things together for your own God. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he, I heard him say, he's gonna move it. He's gonna move it. He's gonna move it. He's gonna move it. He loves you that much. He's gonna move it. He's gonna move it. Exceedingly say, exceeding abundantly. Above all that. Come on, quiet. presence of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yeah. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Praise the Bible the says, Lord, now everybody. Unto him who is able to do yes. exceeding abundantly above all we can ask or think, wow. according to the power yes. that is at work on the inside of
That's
us
right.
today.
That's right.
Now unto him, he's responsible.
That's right.
Amen. That's amen.
Amen.
Well, welcome to church this
welcome.
Morning. We're so glad you're here. My name is Serrano McKenzie. I'm a junior
yes.
at Valor Christian College.
My name is Audrey McKenzie. I am also a junior here at Valor Christian yes. College, and we are so happy to have you all here with us this wonderful Sunday morning. Aren't you glad to be in the house of the Lord today?
Yes,
yes and amen. Well, today is Water Baptism Sunday. Yes, we had people getting baptized
yes.
today, water baptized. So congratulations to all of you, everybody. Let's give them a round of applause. We are so excited for you guys that
Absolutely.
You decided to take that extra step
yep.
and deepen your relationship
yes.
with God. So congratulations on
Absolutely.
That.
Absolutely. Congrats to all our baptism recipients today.
Yes.
Well, if you're in the room, if this is your first time or your first time in a long time,
Woo-hoo.
We want to connect with you today. We want
yes.
to know how you heard about the Harv. So two great ways you can do that. There is a card in the seat back pocket in front of you. We want you to grab that. Fill it out completely and pass it in the offering containers as they go by later in the service. Or you can meet one of our Dream Team members.
Dream team!
Woo, woo, woo. Yes, you can meet one of them in each foyer. There's a free gift there from our pastor. And
oh, yeah.
First Family, we would like to be a great, great, great blessing to you.
We love free around here.
We love free. Free 99.
Free. Yes, online family, don't go anywhere. I'm coming to you right now.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. Well, as she goes to online, you can find all of our weekly announcements at whc.life. I know it's a lot to remember, but we put it there for you each week so that you can avail yourselves to that. Well, it's that most favorite time of the service. Well, one of the most favorite times. It's meet and greet time. Won't you stand?
Woo!
We're going to put 2 minutes on the clock. We want you to meet somebody you've never met before. Let them know you're glad they're here. Go.
Hello, online family. Thank you guys, like we just said, thank you guys so much for joining us today. We love our online family. We wish you could be here with us in person in the tab because there's nothing like being here in the tab on a Sunday morning. But if you can't make it, we understand and we are glad you're joining us online. So we have so many great things going on at the Harv today. Thank you guys for joining us. Make sure you like this video. Make sure you comment, and make sure you share because sharing is the easiest way to evangelize. Make sure that you get this out there to the people you know, the people you care about, and so you can share the love of God with them. So make sure you do that. If you need any additional prayer, make sure that you comment that down in the comment section so we can get with you and agree with you. We have people praying all around the clock. We believe in the power of prayer. We believe that the anointing is transferable. So wherever you're watching, it doesn't matter. God can touch you right where you are. So make sure you comment that so we know and we can agree with you. Make sure you're commenting. Our pastor tells us that he is an audience participation preacher. So make sure you're commenting those fire emojis. I've seen some fire emojis going up, some hand clapping emojis. Somebody put a running emoji, like you're running around the tab. I'd be running around the tab all the time. So put those in there. I see hearts going up. I see hallelujah, praise the Lord, because I'm feeling that in my spirit. I hope you guys are feeling that in your spirit. It is a good day to praise the Lord. So somebody comment down, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. So keep commenting, keep liking, keep sharing. We're going to head back to the tab.
Meeting and greeting. Let's make our way back to our seats. Amen. Y'all are stirred up today, choir, huh? It's always so awesome to have the Harvest Music Live choir with us. You can be seated once you find your way back to your seats. I love having to corral everybody. I love having to do that. We might have to up the meet and greet time to 3 minutes, because 2 minutes doesn't seem like enough time for y'all. We always say we're the biggest little church in Columbus. We're large in size, but we're small in community. We're a tight-knit family here at World Harvest Church. For those of you that don't know me, I'm Ashton Blair. I'm the first daughter here at World Harvest Church. Wow. And I am the proud student pastor of Valor Christian College, the School of Revival. Our students are out on spring break this week, and we miss them so desperately. We had such an amazing weekend last weekend, VIP, with Lizzie Morgan and the Palmers and City Harvest Network and Miss Deborah George out there on the streets winning souls. I think for the year so far, and we're only in, what, the second week of March, we've won over 2,000 souls. I mean, this doesn't happen everywhere. This doesn't happen everywhere. And it's because of all of you and your faithfulness to continue inviting people to church. We so appreciate you doing that. And you watching online, you're not left out. We appreciate you for partnering with us, choosing to make this your church home away from home, from all over the globe. I mean, all over the globe. But I wanted to get up. I kind of rearranged things this morning. I have a tendency to do that every once in a while. You know, throw my creative director weight around. But we have really not had the opportunity to talk to you about all of the incredible things we have going on here for Easter. Easter resurrection season. Pastor was out for 2 weeks, 1 week with a head injury, the next week with laryngitis, and then we jumped into VIP weekend, and then today we've got the kids out on spring break and daylight savings, and it's snowing, and Gender Road is closed, and I mean, the devil was really just working his hardest today, but you're here, and you watching online, you're here, and Elkhart, you're there. You made it, amen. But I said, listen, guys, we got to share with our congregation everything that we're doing for Easter, because again, you're doing such an incredible.
Close to this choir, all on fire. Thank you for your sacrifice. Yeah, it is a sacrifice. Learning all those parts. Ooh, all that stuff.
Was that you being a soprano?
I might have made alto. We love you.
Amen.
Every single one of you, we love you.
Man. And all of our Dream Team members.
Oh, look,
all,
the Dream
Team. All of you that volunteer your time Sunday and Wednesday, in and out.
And guess what?
During the week.
Guess
yes,
what?
Sir.
I'm going to bless them tonight.
Yes.
I got locked away for 10 hours yesterday, and I'm telling you the things the Lord God has given me for tonight. Now look, you might have had a problem with your clock this morning.
Yeah,
but you got it fixed now.
That's right.
Now you're gonna have to get out of your blousy jammies And you're going to have to get on up in here tonight at 6 o'clock because we're not streaming tonight.
Right, we're not live.
Like, you want to get it, you got to come and get it.
That's right, in person.
And I'm going to be serving it up.
Yes, sir.
Fresh and hot. I got stuff tonight I have never, ever, ever shared. And I'm only sharing it with everybody that shows up at 6 o'clock for revival team training. Look, I want to thank this executive service planning team. I know you think this all just kind of falls into place, but there's a dedicated group of about 12 to 15 people that make so much happen. Those meetings are at least 10, sometimes 15 hours a week by 12 to 15 people to make sure that we get you everything we can possibly get to you. And they do an incredible job. And they had to put up with me for all those hours. And I love them for it. And I want you to thank them. And Easter, I mean, we start planning Easter right after Dominion Camp Meeting, which, by the way, is coming up. And I hope you've got your calendar marked off.
July 5, 6, and 7.
July 5, 6, and 7, except for City Harvest Network families, because they begin on Thursday night, which is July 4th.
Yep.
And we've got some extraordinary things planned for them. But tell us a little bit about what we have going for Easter, because usually, you know, I take 7 weeks just informing folks of what's going to go on Good Friday and Easter.
Yes.
But we've got more this year than ever.
So much.
But what I don't want you to lose sight of, I don't want you to lose sight that it's all about the one.
Yes.
Look.
Yes.
The most distant of sinners will come to church on Easter.
Come on.
Easter or Christmas.
Yes.
And what a time to win souls.
Yes.
I want to win 200 or more this Easter.
Yes, yes. Amen.
This Easter.
Amen.
200. I got 5 people agreeing with me.
Amen.
I want to see 200 born again Easter. And that's what we've got our hearts set on. Miles Rutherford, one of our great City Harvest Network pastors, texted me this morning and he said, "Pastor, can you remind me of a couple of statistics I want to share with my church today about winning souls?" So first of all, I shared with him this one. 70% of the people in America will be born in America and die in America, 70%, 7 out of 10, and never one single time ever be invited to church.
Wow.
I spoke a week ago. I haven't shared this with anybody. You like new stuff, right? I haven't even shared this with you. One of the greatest revivals that ever hit America. I'll not tell you where it is because I don't want to identify it that way. But one of the, there were two basically evangelists used in that revival. And one of them said this past week, he said, "Here's where we missed it. We had tens of thousands of people born again. But we had virtually none of the family members of that church born again." But here's the key. They can't come to Jesus if you don't invite them.
Come on. That's right.
We're not asking you to win them.
Yeah.
We're just asking you to get them here.
That's right.
Buy somebody a plane ticket. Tell somebody you'll go out to dinner with them.
Yeah.
Tell them you'll meet them early for breakfast. But what a tragic thing that we should win millions. How many have we won this year? 2,400. Well, it's not there. 2,401 we've already won this year. We have invited a total
34,727.
Say it again.
34,727. No. I think the media equipment is frozen because of the snow out there today. That's all right.
Total number that we have invited, 34,727 is the number. Praise God.
Praise God.
And so, but wouldn't it be tragic if we won 2,400 over this year and we spend Easter capital, if you will. We spend Easter capital and we don't win our families. Father, I just ask right now for a supernatural anointing upon every one of us to bring our families inside this building. God, don't let our families spend eternity in hell separated from you, separated from us for eternity. I ask a special anointing in Jesus' name. And everybody that receives that shouts hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Now, to help us do that.
Yeah, and Pastor, we make it so easy. We make it so easy because we understand sometimes it's intimidating even to invite your own family.
Yeah.
But we have so many resources for you over these next coming weeks, including today. In fact, I have some friends that are going to come out and show us the invitations we have for today. Welcome, Baby Bunny and Brother Bunny.
And we got two more coming.
And we have two more coming. Yes. Okay. So let me talk about the bunny breakfast for a minute. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Because
everybody
listen,
shout bunny breakfast.
Because that's kind of our kickoff to Easter event. Okay. It's the Saturday before Resurrection Weekend, the 23rd. This is an opportunity for you to kind of soft launch the introduction to World Harvest Church, to your friends, to your family, to the lady that you do Pilates with, to the person that barbers your hair. It sometimes people are intimidated even to come to church, but they'll come for a free breakfast and they'll come when they can bring their children. The bunny, if you feed them, they will come. The bunny breakfast was a vision here back in the 90s. I remember the bunny breakfast. I have memories to this day that I made with friends and family members that we still talk about. I even got to be Baby Bunny once. I got to wear the costume and take pictures with the kids. It's just an absolute blast. And one of my dear, dear friends who has literally grown up in this church with me said, you know what? I really miss the bunny breakfast, and it was so successful, and it was such an amazing tool to be able to invite friends and family. We should bring it back. And I said, okay, we will. And I am telling you, this is not just it's not a church potluck, okay? We don't do anything small around here. Can I get an amen? Amen. When I tell you that it is going to look like Peter Rabbit and all things Easter have just exploded and thrown up on this property. There are going to be bunnies everywhere, Easter eggs everywhere. The decorations alone. I mean, I almost started crying when we were working on just the decor. We have so many special things that we're going to do to bless the people that you are going to invite to the bunny breakfast. It's for all intents and purposes, it's for children. It's a an event that is driven toward children, but we want people's entire families to come. It doesn't matter if you got a newborn or if you got an 18-year-old. Bring the whole families. Aunties, bring your nieces and nephews. And grandparents, bring your grandchildren.
And gentlemen.
Yes.
If your wife's coming, come with her. If your children are coming, come on, get off the couch.
Yes.
And get out of this thing. It's going to, look, I don't even want to compare it to Disney World, because the mouse has
nothing on
the bunny breakfast.
Yes.
Tell them what we're going to eat.
Oh, my goodness. We've got, and again, it's all things bunny. It's bunny pancakes. We've got bacon. We've got bunny-shaped eggs. It is a buffet, a literal buffet. We've got breakfast potatoes, and we're doing coffee, and we're doing, you know, kid size apple juices and milk and little cups they can take home and little activity bags they can take to the table. And we're doing photo ops with an entire bunny family, just like that. You don't need to go to the mall to get pictures taken with the Easter Bunny. Come to World Harvest Church on March 23rd at 10 a.m. and have a free breakfast and have a great time. We've got door prizes galore. I mean, we're giving away zoo packages for families and trampoline park packages. And it's just going to be incredible. And it's really, I know I'm taking a lot of time to talk about this, but it's been a burden of my heart because our pastor this time last year said, we're going after kids. We're going after our posterity. We're going after the next generation. This is vision come to life. So we have tools for you to take today. We've got little chocolate bunnies out in the foyers just with our Easter invitations. But then we also have special bunny breakfast invitations. Are these not the cutest thing you've ever seen? And on the back, it's got all the specific bunny breakfast information. So please take advantage of those resources. Leave them at the table at Applebee's today when you go over there with a good tip. Leave it for your Starbucks barista. And again, invite the people in your circle, in your sphere of influence, your community. Give these to your kids to take to school with them. Put them in their book bag, right? So thank you very much, Bunny family. We appreciate you. It's on a Saturday, 10 to 11:30. 10 to 11:30, yes. Kids of all ages, welcome. So that's the first thing, Easter, okay? I took all that time to announce one event that we have going on. Then, of course, on Good Friday, we've got good old-fashioned Holy Communion right here in the tabernacle with Pastor. And then again, for the kids, we're bringing back the Road to the Resurrection Journey with Jesus live walk through the Bible. Bigger, badder, better than ever, your children are going to get to experience the road, the literal road that Jesus took from the Garden of Gethsemane to the Last Supper to Pontius Pilate to the cross to the tomb and resurrection. The entire journey that Jesus took, they're going to be walked through that with live characters and acting and animals. And it's going to teach them and bring the Bible to life for them. Amen. So that's Good Friday at 7 o'clock. Yeah, you can clap for that. Then Easter, and Good Friday, we get to break our fast. I get to reinstall my DoorDash app, and I'm happy about it. If you didn't know, we are right now corporately participating in a 40-day fast. It started 7 weeks out from Good Friday, so we're in week 3 right now. And yeah, jump in. If you say, well, I'm behind, jump in now. It's all right. God knows your heart. God knows your heart. It's fine. Well, I missed a day. That's all right. Just start again. Again, God knows your heart, right? So 40-day fast. We've got our 40-day fasting guide. It's available to you online if you want to participate with us, as thousands around the world are. So Good Friday, we break our fast. We sow our resurrection seed. Yes. I have to say, as some of you don't know what resurrection seed is, if you're new here, is it a topos word, Pastor? It's a topos word. That means it's a word that's specifically for this house, for this house with no expiration date. Right? God spoke to Pastor nearly 40 years ago that this one time a year you celebrate when I gave my best, my only begotten son, by you giving your best. And so people, and I've been so happy to, and just, it's brought such joy to my heart to see people really working to gather their res seed. Because we know that when we sow seed, it has power in itself to multiply. We don't just, when you sow an apple seed, you don't just get one apple, you get an apple tree. And that's how the kingdom of God works. When we release what's in our hand, he releases what's in his. We can't receive with from him with fist tight, right? So I have a friend, and she was telling me, she said, I hope that you don't mind that I've been using the church parking lot to gather my res seed. I was like, explain, please, tell me more. And she said, well, I've been selling everything I can find. I've been turning my house upside down, selling everything I can find, from rugs to baby clothes to shoes. And I've been having people meet me from Facebook Marketplace in the church parking lot. And all the money they're giving me from me selling this stuff is going toward my res seed. That's catching the vision. Amen. Sacrifice. Sacrifice is entry-level Christianity. Okay, so that's Good Friday. Then Easter Resurrection Sunday.
Well, we got communion Good Friday, too.
Yes, I mentioned that, Pastor. Yes. Yeah, that's okay. You missed. That's all right. There's a lot of information. You messed it up. A lot of information. But, of course, Holy Communion on Friday. That's tradition here. Easter Sunday. I mean, what this music team has prepared, what this choir has been rehearsing for weeks, it's going to be incredible. Pastor, of course, will deliver an amazing soul-winning message. As he said, yeah, something about the Bible. Something about the Bible he'll preach. But as we said, you get them in the building, the Holy Spirit will do the rest. Your responsibility is just to invite them. And then the rest is on God. And we know that this place is powerful. It's powerful. This is a place of true life transformation. I mean, even when I was just looking at this choir, I was looking at Lamont. Raise your hand, Lamont, one of our Valor Christian College students. And I was thinking, what a transformation. You know, not a year ago, you were strung out, high as a kite, not knowing you were in your right mind. Your family members were calling your pastor, saying, we can't find him. We don't know where he is. Then when they found you, you didn't know your own name. And Dr. Medina Pullings is his pastor. And she said, that's all right. We're just going to pray and God's going to take care of the rest. And look at you now. Enrolled at Valor Christian College, singing in the choir, becoming a world changer. When you're connected to this place, life transformation happens. And we're believing it's going to happen for you and for your family, whether it's at a bunny breakfast or Easter Sunday. And for the kids on Easter Sunday, we're bringing back the outdoor egg hunt. So that'll happen after service. And they're doing escape. What is it? Oh, Eggscape. You see what we did there? Eggscape. So it's going to be kind of an escape room feel. And they're going to be doing all kinds of puzzles and games and all the things. But we really wanted to highlight that we're doing the outdoor egg hunt again, because it's just always, it's so fun. It's so fun to watch them out there grabbing for those eggs. And in fact, if you come to the bunny breakfast, we're giving you a free basket to then bring back on Easter Sunday to fill up at the egg hunt. And that's not all, as Deborah George would say. That's not all. One last thing. We are so excited, and thank you to Megan Hassett, our chief administrative officer, for being on the phone so we could make this happen, because they were telling us we weren't going to be able to, and she wasn't taking no for an answer. 40,000 pounds of free groceries are going to be distributed to our community from this parking lot after service on Easter Sunday, or for you or someone you know that's in need. And I mean, it's good groceries too. There's fresh meats and produce and dairy and all, you know, it's not some stovetop stuffing and, you know, a pack of macaroni. It's good. Not that there's anything wrong with that, but this is good stuff. Good stuff, because we have a spirit of excellence here, because we serve an excellent God. Amen. So thank you for letting me take so much time. I know it's a lot of information, and I hope you won't just hoard it unto yourself. I hope you'll go share it and invite people to all the things we have going on for Easter. And we'll do Serve Day as well. We always do Serve Day to get the property ready, and we'll give you information about that in the weeks to come. Yep. Amen.
Anybody that can keep all that straight is wonderful, amen? And besides that, she's awful good looking. She looked like her mama. Stand up and say hello to these people. Stand up for Jesus. Elder Canfield, how you doing today? Buddy, it's good to see you. Come up here. I want you to pray for children beginning at this bunny breakfast, yes, all the way through Easter.
Yes, sir.
Because 75% of all adults serving Jesus today,
yes,
accepted him between 13 and 17.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
75%. Wow.
Yeah.
So we got to pray.
Yes.
Will you pray? Stand up.
Yes,
you,
sir,
pray better when you stand.
Amen.
Come on, choir. Get in here now. Agree with Elder Canfield. Let's really ask God,
yes,
to give us those young souls.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for our children, our sons and our daughters, our grandsons and our granddaughters. We thank you, Heavenly Father, that we can pray a hedge of protection around those that are in our families, in our sphere of influence. Satan, we remind you, you cannot touch the people of God and the children of God. You shall not influence or affect our children or our grandchildren. Heavenly Father, we thank you for their eyes coming open to the truth. They'll see Jesus for who he really is. We thank you, Heavenly Father, that they'll recognize him as their Savior and their Lord. God, we call them into the kingdom. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for removing every roadblock, every obstacle that would prevent them from coming to the Lord Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, we remind you that Jesus said, "Suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of heaven." Heavenly Father, we call them from the north and the south, from the east and the west, into your kingdom, into the kingdom of God, into the body of Christ. And we thank you, Heavenly Father, for putting a foundation in them that will never be removed. All of their life long, they will serve you with their strength, and we rejoice in it in the name of Jesus. Somebody lift your voice and praise God in this house. Hallelujah. One of our members, his name is Bill Allison. He and his wife Julie have been part of this church forever. And he was recently given a very difficult diagnosis. One that the doctors say is incurable, but we know that God has the last word. Hallelujah. Pastor Parsley, just this last week, I received a call, actually an email from a young man. He graduated from Valor Christian College. He said, "I had colon cancer when I was a student and God healed me." He said, "I just had some tests and the doctors told me that they found some things in my abdomen. They said there's an 80% chance that it's cancer." I said, "Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna take the 20% chance that it's not cancer and we're gonna pray." I prayed with him. The next day, he emailed me back and said, "Praise God, no cancer." Hallelujah. I just want you to know, God has the last word. I said, God has the last word. Heavenly Father, we lift up Brother Bill Allison to you. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for the healing and miracle-working power of God at work in his body. We thank you, Lord God, for doing a supernatural, creative miracle in him. We thank you for raising him up and restoring him in the name of Jesus. And God, we pray also for everyone who's received a negative report, a difficult diagnosis. And we thank you, Heavenly Father, for causing their faith to be encouraged today. Raise them up by the power of your Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. Somebody shout like you believe that it's true.
When you said, Elder Canfield, that God has the last word.
Yes.
Because I've been feeling stirred in my spirit to share this all day. And I said, well, Lord, if I hear it three times, I'll know it's you. And as soon as you said that, it as Clint Brown said, it made my baby jump.
Yes.
And so last night, I had a friend of nearly 20 years now. She was calling me, and I had my phone on D&D because I got in bed early because of this time change situation,
yes,
right?
Yes.
And I knew I had to come to church. And I looked at my phone, and she's saying, please call me. So I call her back, and I said, what's going on? Are you okay? And sobbing uncontrollably, like I've never heard anybody scream and cry. And she said, I just want to end it all. I can't take it anymore. I just want to die, Ashton. I can't do this anymore. I'm at the end of my rope. I feel like there's no hope. I'm telling you. But all I could do was just call you. You're the only person that I could think of to call. And this is an unsaved. This is a person that is not saved.
All right.
That's not saved. But something told her to call me. Not because it's me, but because of the authority that is inside of me. The same power that raised to life again the three-day dead body of the Prince of God. And I said, you're gonna live and not die. I bind that spirit of suicide in the name of Jesus. I bind and rebuke every lie of the enemy that says you have no hope, that says you have no future. I cast it down now in the name of Jesus. I bind depression and anxiety and bipolar disorder and all mental illness that wouldn't misinform your mind that you must die and not live. I command life to come forth, life to spring forth in the name of Jesus. And God had the last word in that situation, Elder Canfield, because after I was able to talk with her and pray with her, she calmed down and she said, everything's gonna be okay.
Yeah.
I know everything's gonna be okay. I don't know how it's gonna be okay, but I know that it's gonna be okay. And you may be facing a situation right now that looks like it's not gonna be okay. You don't have to know how it's gonna happen. All you have to do is have faith that it's gonna happen. We serve a God that is a way maker, a miracle worker. He makes the way where there is no way
in
the natural. And we believe fact. We don't deny fact, but we stand on truth.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
The fact was our pastor had vocal cord cancer. We didn't deny that fact, but we knew the truth of the word of God, which said he was bruised for our iniquities. He was beaten for our transgressions. The chastisement of our peace was laid upon him. And by his stripes, we are and were healed and made whole. Shout praises for it!
If you need healing in your physical body, or in your spirit, or in your mind, will, emotions, whatever it is, if you need a healing in your finances, if you need a healing in your marriage, with your relationships with your family, come on down here to this altar. Something is happening in the house this morning, and you need to take advantage of it. Get down here and receive the miracle that God has in mind for you this morning.
Exceedingly, abundantly, above all that.
Come on, get in here.
Abundantly.
Come on, get in here.
We ask
Get as close as you can. Come on, there's room for everybody that needs it. Don't hesitate. Don't stop until you get here.
Above all that, we ask all
my God.
Exceedingly, abundantly, above all that, we ask all things. Exceedingly, abundantly, above all that.
More than enough, too much, double for your trouble. Thank God. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Above all that, we ask all things.
God has orchestrated something for you this morning that is beyond your imagination and beyond your expectation.
We ask all things exceedingly, abundantly. Above all that, we ask all things exceedingly, abundantly. Above all that, we ask all things.
All right, Elder, you know. You know that during resurrection season,
yes,
leading up to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ, when yes, we celebrate,
yes, sir,
is marked for 39 years. Now, we've already heard more miracles today,
yes,
than most places will hear in 3 years.
Yes, sir.
But we're going to have more.
Hey.
Yes, 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 yes.
Hey. I said we're going to have more.
Yes, yes, sir. Yes.
This is a miracle place.
Yes, it is.
I'm hearing God deal with me.
Yes, yes.
Over about the last 6 weeks regarding miracle healing and victory service.
Oh!
I'm about ready to fill this place up with wheelchairs, walkers, and canes, and hearing aids, and people on hospital beds. I'm about ready for that. Well, I better wait, because sure don't sound like you're ready for it. I better wait till you get back in the Word and get your faith raised up. Amen. But today, we believe in agreement. In agreement.
In agreement.
One chases a thousand. Two puts 10,000 to flight.
Yeah.
Look at somebody and say, you better not leave me. I need a miracle. I need a healing. I need a deliverance. I need a breakthrough. And I just heard the Holy Ghost jump up in me and say, tell them their wait is over.
Oh!
Oh! I heard. Start shouting, my wait is over. My wait is over.
I'm Tyler Smith. Tyler Smith, that's for you and your wife. Your wait is over, Tyler Smith and Tyler Smith's wife. Your wait is over. I don't know what that means for you, but I'm telling you, it's for you. The wait is over. Acceleration is coming to the miracle that you're believing for. Acceleration is coming in Jesus' name.
Go ahead, Elder.
Pastor Parsley, you said that 2024 is the year of the open door.
Right.
There are doors that people have had closed for them that are about to come open by the power of God in this place.
And he said he'll open it and no man can close.
That's
it.
Right.
I dare
That's
you to
right.
get the shouting, jumping, spinning, running, leaping.
We ask all things, exceedingly, above all that, we ask all things.
What's going on with my dear friend? What's going on? What's going on?
I came down with an ugly disease called cellulitis. I never heard of it. My whole leg and foot was blood red, and I was in the hospital for a week and then in a nursing home.
In 7 days,
yeah. Come on, come on, come on, come on.
You'll shout.
Come on.
Yeah. that it's gone. Hey, hey. God's going to give you that week in the hospital back, and by then it'll all be gone. Somebody get to shouting this miracle time. Shout because you believe in a God of miracles. Shout because you come on. Okay, here's what I feel. I feel a waiting spirit. Waiting. Like at the pool of Bethesda. Now, for those of you that don't know your Bible, that's where a lame man lay. I don't know how many years, decades, he laid there. And one time a year, God is a God of timing. No, see, you hear me say that, but you don't get it. God is a God of timing. Yeah. And he just told me your alarm's going off. Oh. God said, wake up to my miracle. It's time. When I was in my early 20s, the Holy Ghost gave me a word called the someday syndrome. In fact, it was the second book I ever wrote. It was in the 1980s. About 1982, maybe 83. And God gave me a word called the someday syndrome of people that are always waiting. Well, someday. If you're believing it someday, you're not really believing it. Because your someday is today. Yes. Because Mark 11, 22 to 24 says, have faith in God. Now, here's how you can tell whether you're having faith in God or faith in time. Because when you have faith in God, you say to this mountain, be thou removed, be thou cast into the sea. You say, well, why doesn't God say it? He did. 2,000 years ago, the seventh completion thing, Jesus said, it is finished. So whatever it is, if you can name it, it is finished. Now, Luke chapter 4, Jesus said, it was delivered to him, the book of the prophet Isaiah. And he, standing up for to read, found the place where it was written and began to say, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Now, you struggling to get your resurrection seed, better hear me. The first anointing that Jesus announced was the anointing to bring you out of just enough poverty. He said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me to preach gospel, the acceptable year of the Lord, the gospel, right? The acceptable year of the Lord, an appointed time.
An appointed time.
Three times a year, Easter, Pentecost, Tabernacle. At an appointed time at the pool of Bethesda when the waters were troubled, an angel came down one time a year and troubled the water. And whoever was the first to step in got healed. And you know what that lame man said? Jesus came by and Jesus said, you want to be healed? And he said, I have no man. Why why you got your eyes on me. You like Humpty Dumpty.
Humpty Dumpty.
Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty together again. Why didn't they ask the king? What they mess around with horses and men for? Why are you listening to men? God gave you his word.
Yeah.
So, Jesus said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Say it.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me.
For God has anointed me.
For God has anointed me.
To preach the acceptable year of the Lord.
To preach the acceptable year of the Lord.
Which is right now.
Which is right now.
This is Jubilee.
This is Jubilee.
50th year.
50th year.
Of my pastor's anointing.
Of my pastor's anointing.
It is Passover.
It is Passover.
Miracle time.
Miracle time.
This is my time.
This is my
for
time.
My thing.
For my thing.
From my God.
From my God.
I'm not leaving,
this
altar,
without it.
Without it. Today.
Today.
Because Jesus went on.
Yeah.
Because he said it's the acceptable year of the Lord. To the Jewish people,
yes.
That meant on their calendar, at Jubilee, once every Sabbath of years, plus one, 49 plus one, 50. Jubilee. Everybody goes free. Everybody gets healed. All the debts are canceled.
Oh, yes.
I need somebody to shout that believes God is going to cancel your debt.
Yeah! Yeah.
I can't ask him to cancel mine because I ain't got none. I've been free from debt since I was 27 years old. Hallelujah.
What's in the head gets in the body. As long as the parts of the body stay attached to the head.
You know, I just heard the Holy Ghost tell me to say this. Some folk don't like their head. They don't like their head. They get in front. I just love these filters on social media. And now people been showing with and without the filter. Some folks don't like their head. They don't like their spiritual head. Well, that's okay. You just don't get what flows from
it. That's right.
Better find you one you like. Get on the internet. You know what that's like? When you go home, stick your finger in a glass of water and pull it out. That's how much difference you make. But everybody, did you hear what the elder said?
Yes.
That stays connected.
Connected, yeah.
That stays connected. Spirit, soul, body, and money.
Money.
You know how I tell how connected people are? I look at their money. Boy, some of you are special. They'll slice that tithe 25 cents a week. 1 week you get a quarter. The next three you don't. The next week you get a quarter added on the end. What must God do? I think he just goes, seriously?
Let's slice their blessing.
Yeah. Seriously? Right? Stop that stuff.
Yeah.
Get in. get all the way in.
All the way in.
I said, get all the way in.
All the way in.
I had a quote ready for him today. It said, if a man's religion does not affect his money, his religion is vain.
Well,
okay, I got three ladies down here who are obviously tithers clapping right now. Do you know that God can't bless you past your last act of disobedience?
It's true.
And right now he's showing you when it was. That's the way the Holy Spirit works. Now then, Jesus said, I'm back to the someday syndrome. Jesus said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, the recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord.
Yes.
And he closed the book, and then he said to all who are listening,
yes,
this day uh-huh, is this scripture fulfilled in your ears.
That's what he said.
Meaning, whenever you hear it,
hey,
that's the day.
That's the day. That day.
Ain't everybody down here hearing it, but some folk hearing it. Say, today,
today
is the day.
Is the day.
Today,
today
is the day.
Is the day.
It goes today.
It's
broken today.
Today. Broken
I'm
today.
Free today.
Free
I'm
today.
Forgiven today.
Forgiven.
The burden is lifted today.
Today.
My body is healed today. My debts are paid today. I'm going to give you 60 seconds to act like you got it. You got 15 seconds. I turn it up. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Give him the greatest praise of the day. Praise till you got it. Praise till you got it.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Shout all the way back to your seat.
My sound is a weapon. 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 My sound.
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 My sound
to the Lord is
my sound.
My sound.
My
sound. Say yeah.
One more good shout. You may be seated. Turn your Bible, John. The Gospel of John, chapter 17. John, chapter 17, verse 17. You want to just write it down? Just write it down. They probably got it up here for you. It simply says, Jesus speaking, says, Father, sanctify them. Sanctify. What's it mean? Set apart. Distinguish them. Make them head and shoulders above everybody else. Separate them. Make them unique. Make them a royal priesthood. Make them a holy nation. Make everybody be able to see that they are not ordinary. Say, I'm not ordinary.
I'm not ordinary.
I'm extraordinary. I'm above, and I'm not beneath. I'm the first. I'm not the last. I'm the head, and I am not the tail. I'm blessed when I come in. I'll be more blessed when I go out. I'm blessed at my house. I'm blessed on the highway. I'm blessed when I wake up. I'm blessed when I go to bed. My children rise up and call me blessed. I am blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. Father, sanctify them. I have a question for you. Jesus of Nazareth stood outside the tomb of his friend Lazarus. Lazarus had been dead 4 days. Jesus said, Lazarus, come forth. Now, if he had not designated by using his name, and were he not standing at his tomb, had he just said, come forth, every grave in Jerusalem would have burst open. In fact, it was a precursor, because what brought Jesus out of the tomb on Easter morning was a word spoken by King David, the sweet psalmist of Israel, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years earlier. For David said concerning him, it is not possible that death could hold him. And that word was in the atmosphere for just the right time, at just the right place, to do just the right thing, because not one word of his will fall to the ground void of power, and will accomplish everything he sent it into the earth to do. Sanctify them. I got all that out of sanctify them. Through your truth, your word is truth. Now, facts may argue, but they will have to bow their knee to truth, because you can't bury the truth. Y'all making me want to preach today. You can't bury the truth, it'll resurrect itself, because a seed has life in itself. They took seeds from the tomb of Tutankhamun, King Tut. Been in there for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years. They took that seed. They put it in the soil. Because not only is seed important, soil is important. Help me, choir. I said soil is important. Jesus said the sower goes forth to sow the seed. Some of it falls on rocky ground and dies. Some of it falls on hard ground and dies. Some of it gets sown among weeds. That's all your negative friends. And the negative friends rise up, and religion rises up and chokes out the seed. But then there is 25% a good seed that falls in good soil, and it springs up and bears much fruit. Here's good gospel news. You get to choose what kind of seed you sow, what kind of soil you put it in, and whether or not you're going to have a harvest. I see people all the time, well, I sowed. I didn't get nary a harvest. Number one, you had corrupted seed. Obedient seed is the only seed that's not corrupted. You didn't hear me. You sowed corrupted seed, or you sowed the seed among thorns and thistles. Stop giving to people going under. We've been here 47 years. Same pastor, same wife, 47 years. Still here. Still preaching the same thing. Still seeing souls won. Still seeing bodies healed. Still seeing miracles. Raising up young people, sending them all over the earth. Raising up preachers, sending them around the world. Good soil. But you also have to pay attention to season. Now, in the next few days, you're going to see those big old plows going up and down those furrowed roads all across the beautiful state of Ohio, all across the Midwest, the breadbasket of the world. There it'll go. Planting seed. Because it's springtime. Isn't it interesting? That's when God sowed his seed, his son, his best. God needed a family, so he sowed a son. Father, sanctify them through your truth. Your word is truth. Now get this now. The only way anybody, including me, can change your future. Do you know what brings depression? Hopelessness. Do you know what hopelessness is? That tomorrow will be no different than today. That's a hopeless person. A person in that situation does not have a future. This is why people are taking their lives in unprecedented numbers. We're in perilous times. People don't see an answer. And when you don't see that your tomorrow can be better than today, you'll be in depression. You have to have something called hope. And I'm just the guy to give it to you. Now, the only way anyone can change your future, watch me, is to change whose words you trust. That's it. So my question is, who you been listening to? TV, there's no hope there. The Democrats will tell you it's the Republicans. The Republicans will tell you it's the Democrats. The independents will tell you they've got the answer to it all, and they ain't never even been in office. I'm just saying, who are you listening to? Who are you listening to? I'll tell you who I listen to. I listen to the words of that book over there.
Amen.
That's what I listen to.
Yep. Amen.
That's what we need to listen to. So the Bible says, let the weak say, I'm strong. Let the weak say, I'm strong. Okay, I got a third of you. Now, I ought to be getting more than a third of them with the choir up here. All right? Let the weak say,
I'm strong.
Everybody, let the weak say,
I'm strong.
Let the poor say, well, I can't say I'm rich. Well, just keep saying you're poor. The only way I can change your future is to change whose words you believe. Here's why. You will repeat the words you believe. Meaning, today is the future you talked about yesterday. Ain't got no help in here. I ain't got no help in here. You sit right smack dab in the middle of what you said. So we're going to ask some questions. How many of you like questions? Question number one, who has your money? Don't answer. Who has your money? Do you know the Bible tells you? This book tells you who's got your money. Now, don't be sitting there acting like you got your money. Like you got your car. You don't own no car, truck neither. You making payments on it. Soon as you miss three, see whose truck it is. Well, I own my home. I have the American dream. The American dream is not to buy a $100,000 home on a 30-year mortgage and end up paying $600,000 over that 30 years for a $100,000 house. That ain't even smart. You don't own it till that title says you own it. So I'm going to tell you, according to the Bible, who's got your money? You ready? Proverbs 13, the wealth of the sinner is laid up, held in store for the righteous. The devil's got your money. Now, if I came down here, hard to find anymore because most women don't carry a purse. Most men have started. Now, if she really thought I was leaving with this, I know her. I know her three boys, I know her daughter, and I know her husband. But mostly, I know her. She's not letting me out of here with her money. So my question is, why are you letting the devil keep yours? Number two, where is your money supposed to be? The book says wealth and riches are in your house. Your money is not supposed to be with the devil. Your money is supposed to be in your house. Meaning, you're supposed to have it. If you own it, you control it. But if you don't own it, you can't control it. You with me so far? God gives you power. Shout, I have power. It is the Lord your God who gives you the power to get wealth. So how come you ain't got none? He gives you the power. And look, that's not some spooky thing. That's brain power. Huh? That's will power. That's physical power. That's mental acumen. The only difference between those that you perceive to be wealthy or the 1%, the 1%, they know something you don't know because they listen to somebody you haven't listened to. You're not liking me. No, you're not liking me. I can tell. Can you feel it? Yeah. You're not liking me. God gave you the power to get wealth. So stop blaming God. Stop. I wanted to preach this for you today, but I don't have time. Stop saying money is evil. Church folk galore will tell you that and tell you the Bible says that. The Bible says no such thing, and those that would perpetrate such an untruth are untruthful. That's not true. The Bible never says money is evil. And by the way, if money is evil, you shouldn't go to work tomorrow. Because the only reason you're going to work tomorrow is to get. Excuse me while I make so much sense. Money is not evil. Money is benign. Money is neither good nor evil. Money can be used for good, or money can be used for evil, depending on who's got the money. Well, I wouldn't want God to bless me. I wouldn't want to be in the 1%. First of all, you're not being truthful. You mean to tell me if I wrote you out a check for $1 million and handed it to you, you'd refuse me because you're so holy? Dear Lord, people are shooting each other over $10. Money's not evil. Money is just a method of conveyance for things you want or need. That's it. Neither good nor evil. Stop saying that. You're living a lie. You're talking out of both sides of your mouth. Money's evil. Okay, So you got your meter, right? Okay. Because at some point, money's fine. You have no problem. Do you? You have no problem. Go around telling everybody, your boss is mean and you deserve a raise. Because you breathed for another year. Maybe it's not your boss's mean. Maybe you just need to work. Maybe you need to stop showing up late. Maybe you need to stop having to be told exactly the same thing 15 times. Or maybe your boss is a jerk. I don't know. Fact of the matter is, don't have anything to do with you. Because your boss is not your source. That's your problem. Is anybody with me? God said, the evil one or evil people have your money. My question is, what are you going to do about it? Because your money, according to God's word, is supposed to be in your hands. Number three, God gives you the power to get wealth. Notice he did not say money. He said wealth. You with me? Okay. There are five different kinds of wealth. I'll give them to you in a minute. First of all, where is the power that God gave you to get wealth? Where is it? I'm asking redundant questions. They're questions I know the answer to. And they're all from your Bible. The power is in you. Already. It's already in there. Right now. Now, that doesn't mean you have to use it. You have power to stand up right now, but you're not using it. Maybe it's not an appropriate time. I don't know. Ephesians 3:20, now unto him who is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to his power which is at work in us. So there is power working in you right now to get wealth, to get your money in your house and out of whoever else has got it. Have I made sense so far? Now let me give you five areas of wealth. Five areas of wealth. Number one, there's financial wealth. That's only one kind. Financial wealth. If you want to be in the 1%, you're going to need to make about $650,000 a year. And you're going to have a little over $11 million of an estate. That puts you in the 1%. Stop being mad at them. Unless they got their money dealing drugs or sex trafficking or gambling or some other nefarious way. You know, there are actually people that work hard for what they have. They're actually people that have a mind that will grasp a hold of things. There are actually people who, through sheer obedience to God and a work ethic, got what they've got. Everybody that has wealth is not a devil. Stop hating them. They pay 70% of the taxes that you enjoy driving up and down the road. It's amazing to me how many people complain about taxes that don't pay any. Number two, that financial wealth, that's your possessions and your money. Right? Number two, social wealth. status, acceptance, influence. That's a kind of wealth. Number three, here's a big one, time. Time. Because they're not making any more of it. And remember this about real estate. Remember this. They're not making any more land either. Be careful what you do with land. Land is an extremely valuable commodity. Time, that means freedom, right? Number four type of wealth, physical wealth. Man, you ought to shout today. I was so glad when they put two hospitals in Pickerington, right? Because every time I go by them, I get to rejoice that I'm not in there. Come on, man. You got your mind about you. You know what day of the week it is. You can get from one place to the other. You can drive your car. You can push your grocery cart. Man, you are wealthy. Let it be taken away from you, and you'll see how wealthy you were. Number five, spiritual wealth. Peace of mind, heart, and spirit. Self-respect. Those are five basic categories of wealth. Now, don't miss what I'm about to say. If you don't get anything else, get this. Do not, let me say it this way. Be cautious of people, positions, education, careers, that will get you drawn to one and two and rob you of three, four, and five. So let's see one. Financial wealth can rob you of three, four, and five. Rob you of your time, which is freedom. Rob you of your health. And rob you of your spiritual life. Because you're chasing money, which you think is evil. Number two is what kind of wealth? Social wealth. Status. Leave me out. I'm busy. Acceptance, status, influence will rob you of your most valuable commodity, time. Two, it will rob you of your physical and mental health. Three, it'll destroy your spirit. Did you get it? I said, did you get it? All right. Now we're going to see if you have money idolatry. Money is the number one idol in the United States of America. How do you know that? People give their time to it. They give their energy to it. They give their mind to it. They give their spirits to it. They don't have time for God. They're working 40 hours a week and get mad if church goes past 11:30. No devotional life. Don't have time to read the devotion. Don't have time to read the 40-day fast. And then you've been spending all your time to get money. And when the preacher come along and say, it's time to tithe, If money doesn't mean so much to you, why don't you just give it? If it's so evil, I got great places for you to get rid of it. I mean, if it's really bugging you, just make a big check. It is a terrible thing that America is in the situation it's in, politically and every other way, for one reason. They've got you living paycheck to paycheck. I use this term cautiously. You are an indentured servant. You're serving your house note. You're serving your car note. You're serving your credit card bills. Do you know the credit card bills in the United States of America right now are the highest in history? History. 22% interest. Financing a lifestyle you can't afford because you're driven for acceptance. You want everybody seeing you drive that car. My daddy'd say, now he quit preaching and gone to meddling. Okay? Did you learn anything from that little? All right. Come on. We're going to go after the wealth that belongs to us. Father, bless every person who's preparing their resurrection seed at this time, in this season, according to your word. Bless us to forever stay in obedience with our tithes and our offerings. Look down and bless your people in Jesus' name. You're going to give now. The way to give is on the screen, and the ways to give is on the big screen. And I believe we've got one great choir who've been standing here the whole time. Think of all the calories you burn. Isn't that great? Amen. Tell the choir you love them.
Anybody believe the blood still works? Hallelujah! It still works to save, heal, and deliver. All right, keep it, band, but just bring it down a little bit. Are we still online as well? We're gonna say yes. Everybody online, their Elkhart social media, and here in this room, we've been singing, the blood still works. You believe it? If the trumpet of God was to sound right now, and you're not sure where you would spend eternity, we want to give you that moment right now to let you know that the blood still works. There's no sin too big, no past too great that the blood can't cover. Amen. So we believe that salvation is made through confession. So if you want to make Jesus the Lord of your life, now listen, it's not just heaven on the other side of that trumpet blast, but you can have heaven on this side of eternity. It's not that we don't go through some things, but we got Jesus to take us through and make it better. Amen. So we're going to give you a moment to receive Jesus as the Lord of your life, okay? We're all going to pray this out together. I'm going to say a prayer, and from your heart, you're going to repeat it, and Jesus is going to come and take over. Amen? All right, everybody, here we go. Repeat after me. Jesus, I believe you came, you died, you rose again. Today, I receive you as my personal Lord and Savior. I will never be the same. I will never be the same. I will never be the same. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, put an amen on it. Hallelujah. If you gave your life to Jesus today or rededicated your life to him, we just want you to take a moment, and there at your seat, there's a card. Fill that out that you gave your life to him, and we want to connect with you and get you some material to walk out your faith. This is the best day of your life. Amen. All right. If you didn't get a chance to give, ushers will be at the doors. Revival team class is tonight at 6 o'clock, right? Get you some food, a little short nap, and then come back in here. We start like prompt right at 6. So come back, bring somebody with you. Fasting guides that we've been talking about, they're available in all of our foyers, so you can take advantage of that today as you leave. Orthodoxy, what we believe and why, this Wednesday night, 7 o'clock. First-time guests, don't forget, we would love to connect with you. Go to any of those new here kiosks out there, and we'd love to meet you and give you a free gift. And all the announcements, Easter and more, at whc.life. God bless you, and we'll see you back here tonight right at 6 o'clock.
What an awesome service.
That was a good service.
Wow. Thank you for being right there joining us.
Yes, absolutely. Yes, service has been so good.
Uh-huh.
Yes, if you said that prayer, make sure you put a 1 in the comments.
Yeah.
And then we will be able to send you some free literature, an ebook called New Direction.
Click that link. We want to get that for you. Put that 1 in the comment. Then everybody else, go and like that 1. Welcome them to the family of God. Be sure to click that link and get that ebook. Well, what's happening this Wednesday?
This Wednesday, we have with Dr. Rod Parsley, our pastor, Orthodoxy, What We Believe and Why. When I tell you, these have been so power-packed with teaching.
Amazing.
Every time I learn something that I've never learned before. I learn a lot of things that I've never learned before. Make sure you come Wednesday night, 7 p.m., Orthodoxy, What We Believe and Why.
We want to see you there. Well, if you haven't made yourself available to our giving and offering opportunity, please be sure to do that. You can sow into the ministry. God will bless you tremendously for that. So make yourself available to that today. Well, it was a wonderful day. We were so glad that you were here.
We hope that you were blessed,
that you were encouraged, strengthened, healed, and all the things.
All the things.
God bless you, and we will see you Wednesday right here, 7 p.m.
Sowing into the kingdom of God has never been easier or more secure than with Smart Giving. Any smartphone will work. To use your Smart Giving, open your text messaging app and send a message to number 45777. In the message of your text, type the amount of your gift, space WHC. If it's your first time giving, you'll receive a secure link to set up your account. Select your home campus, enter your giving method, and where you would like to receive your instant giving receipt. If you already registered, the process is the same. Just send a text message to 45777, type the amount of your gift, space WHC. You'll receive your receipt immediately. If you prefer, you can also sow online at whc.life or by phone or mail. Just call the number on your screen or send your gift to the address displayed.
Grace, I sing the song of the reed.